Our topic of discussion is today. Our topic of discussion is optics. In optics, basically, we have to discuss the interference. What is the interference? How to understand the concept of interference? It is important. In general, we define that interference is a result of superposition principle. Superposition of two waves or more than two waves. So superposition principle. In this superposition principle, basically what happens? Two waves of same frequency, same wavelength, basically overlaps, and as a result they produce a resultant wave of, suppose displacement is capital Y here in this situation, third case, and in the first case displacement is suppose y1, for the second wave displacement is y2, then the resultant displacement of this wave y will be equal to y1 plus y2. This is algebraic sum of the displacements. At y-axis we are considering displacement, and this is the time displacement y, and this is the time displacement and time. So superposition principle says that when two or more than two waves superimpose, they produce a resultant wave, and the amplitude of the resultant wave will be sum of the algebraic sum of the resultant, algebraic sum of the amplitude. So y is the resultant amplitude, where y1 and y2 are the displacement of the y1 of the wave 1 and wave 2. This one is the resultant wave, maximum amplitude is y. Now before we go into the detail of interference and realize this superposition principle, it is important for us that we understand the concept related to the wave. What is a wave, and some basic terminology which comes into the wave theory. So this portion is known as the wavelength, represented by lambda. This is wave length, the distance of one cycle, one semicircle and other lower semicircle. This distance is known as the wavelength of the wave. At y-axis we measure the amplitude, so maximum displacement is known as the amplitude. Frequency, how many cycle basically this wave complete in a 1 second, represented by nu, is equal to 1 upon t, and the unit of this is second inverse. This is the frequency. Frequency, how many cycle basically this wave complete in a 1 second. That will be the frequency. This is the wavelength, amplitude. Now phase, what is the phase or phase difference between two or more than two waves? Phase difference. So the next concept is phase or phase difference. It will be better if we, so how to explain basically this phase or phase difference with the this wave starts from the origin, and if I start one more wave from the origin, so I am saying that there is no phase difference between these two waves. But if a wave starts from here, so that will basically goes like in this way and follow this path, so there will be some phase difference. So how much this is positive or negative, it depends on the position on y axis. So in our case we can show also this through the circular motion. If a particle start from this position, suppose that is A, starts to move from here initially at t is equal to 0, that time is basically at the origin. When this particle reach at the B point, suppose that time is t2, so correspond to this point the representation on xy axis will be this one. When this particle reach up to the C point, the representation of this point on graphical axis that will be correspond to this one. And now particle reach up to the D point in a circular motion, so that point will be correspond to the this point, and again reach up to the original point, that is correspond to the this point. So this is the A, this one is the B, this one is the C, and this one is the D, and again A, B, C, D. So we are observing that a particle in a circular motion is correspond to a wave, simple harmonic motion. So phase, when particle starts to move from A position, that is correspond to this wave, and this wave start from the origin. But if suppose a particle start to move from R point, that will be correspond to the this point. And now suppose that making an angle theta with the origin, with respect to this horizontal axis. So now theta is that angle, theta is the phase difference between the two waves which starts from A and from the point P. Now if we know, we know that if there is a phase difference, there will be path difference, both are connected to each other. So phase difference is equal to 2 pi upon lambda into path difference. If I know the phase difference, I can find out the path difference. Path difference, similarly, lambda upon 2 pi into phase difference. So this is the path difference, and through this one can find out the phase difference. So both the terms are very important in case of this interference, to understand the concept of interference. So these are the basic terminology. One more thing here, frequency. Here we are saying omega, angular frequency. So omega is equal to 2 pi nu, where omega is the angular frequency. Omega is the angular frequency. So through this we can connect, we can find out the relationship between the frequency of the wave. This nu is represented by the frequency of wave, and omega is the angular frequency, and this is the relationship between these two, where nu is equal to 1 upon t. So these are the basic terminology. If we basically try to explain this interference, so this interference basically comes into the wave theory. So optics is categorized into two parts. One is geometrical optics and second is wave optics. In our case, basically we are studying this wave optics, where light basically treated as a wave. So light is treated as a wave instead of ray. So this wave have this kind of nature, and as you know that wave are further of two types, longitudinal wave and transverse wave. Longitudinal waves are sound waves. Sound waves are longitudinal waves. Light wave basically light wave is an example of transverse wave. So what is the difference between the transverse wave and the longitudinal wave? This one and two. Further, transverse wave and longitudinal wave. In the transverse wave, basically particles vibrate perpendicular to the direction of propagation of the wave, vibrations. So these are the vibrations, maximum vibration nearby to the source, and then after the vibrations amplitude decreases with respect to the distance. And this is the definition of transverse nature of the wave. Medium particles vibrate perpendicular to the direction of propagation, and in longitudinal basically particles vibrate into the direction of the wave, and with respect to the distance the displacement basically decreases. So these are the two types of longitudinal wave and transverse wave. Light wave basically is the transverse wave, and we have to explain this on the basis of